Welcome to this week's episode. We are starting a three-part series on trade show success. It is only July, but October will be upon us sooner than we can imagine. And NBAA is our biggest show of the year. Of course, there's a lot of other shows during the summer that a lot of this applies to. So if you're spending a lot of money and a lot of time and a lot of energy on trade shows, you want to make sure that they are really worth it to you. So we're talking with Mark Leeper, who is the founder and president of Seabright Company, a consulting firm serving the aviation industry since 2000. His valued clients include Part 91, Part 135 flight departments, aviation insurance companies, flight training organizations, and Part 145 repairs facilities. Mark is a licensed pilot with advanced upset recognition and recovery training in single and multi-engine jets. And he is a member of the NBAA, the Arizona Business Aviation Association, and a past board member of the Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University Safety Committee. Mark and Carolyn are also great partners of ABCI. We've worked together with Seabright Company on a lot of different projects, including trade shows, where we've worked to get some really great results for aviation companies who are exhibiting at those trade shows and maybe don't have the personnel to do all the strategy and prep and invitations and sales process and follow-up and execution that needs to be done to make it a real big success. So we love working with these guys on different projects, and we love working with your company as well to make your next trade show exhibit a success. You can visit seabrightcompany.com/NBAA for details of some of the packages that we offer for trade show support. Well, thanks, Mark, for taking some time. I know it's getting to be a real busy time of year for you.
Well, thank you for having me, and appreciate the opportunity. It is becoming a busy time of year. We're getting, believe it or not, close to NBAA in October. It's 108 degrees here in Phoenix, and pretty soon we're going to be in Las Vegas at the big show. So again,
right, time flies so fast. It was just barely spring, you know. So I think a lot of people are thinking NBAA is a million years away, but I was hoping, you know, we could talk today about three things and. Mark, you and I and Carolyn and John, of course, have worked on a lot of trade shows together and have had a few successful ones under our belt, which it makes it really fun to work together.
Absolutely. Thank you.
No problem. So I was hoping we could talk about maybe three things that salespeople can do to prepare for the trade show, things that people should be thinking about right now as they're getting into summer.
Well, you know, one of the things that we learned from ABCI was the amount of the importance of preparing for the trade show. A lot of people's attitudes going into a trade show are that they're worried about making the plane, getting the Uber to the show, and setting the exhibit up, and then everybody's going to rush up to the booth, and you're going to do your presentation and go home. The success of this really starts in the preparation part of this. You need to treat this as an invitation process and secure some key appointments to bring people to your exhibit. It all depends, of course, on what your product is. If you're selling millions of widgets, you've got a little bit different mission than you are if you're selling million-dollar consulting contracts. But again, it boils down to finding, you know, your top 10 list. And who can you invite and set up appointments at the show? Just like you would at your business, you know, you want to set up appointments with people. So you track them. You start to call them now.
Yeah.
Ask who's coming to the show. You start sending materials out that ABCI is so good at producing to invite them, to remind them. So it's that would be a huge thing, is that preparation.
Right. And people think, you know, this is a really long show. People will just come see us sometime while they're there. But people get so busy because they're getting to have so many exhibitors and so many educational events and so many other things that are like demands on people's time, that I think unless you secure those appointments early, chances are they just won't happen. If it's just we'll see you at the show, that never happens, right?
Well, exactly. I think several years ago, we were working on a project together that started in August, and we didn't really have a much of a customer list. We started dialing, you know, for contacts. And I was amazed being on the phone for a month, how many people had already had their show planned out completely. Yeah. So I was hearing a lot from key people. Well, I'm at this educational seminar, then I'm meeting with this company and this company and this company and this company. And then I've got a luncheon, or I've got a, you know, a dinner engagement, cocktail, whatever it is. So they really get busy at these shows. And another good point you just made is that, you know, with all the effort that goes into NBAA especially, it's really a Tuesday, Wednesday, and everybody starts running for the airport Thursday type
situation. Right. They're just dead.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's really half day on Thursday. A lot of people head out to, and I'm talking about NBA a lot specifically here, but any trade show, you know, the first part of it's real busy and people start leaving in the last quarter of the shows to go home.
Yes.
Yeah. It's that prep. And then I think you asked, you know, the three things, you know, you've got to have a specific plan in place to conduct presentations. And it depends on your industry and your product, of course. But it's all about getting people to your exhibit for a reason and being prepared to meet their needs. I know, like you said, there's, you know, 500,000 people in the arena, but you've got maybe 3 or 4 or 5 great opportunities.
Right.
You know, to capitalize on your investment so you get a return. So a lot, it's in that preparation.
Exactly. So, you know, when you're planning your presentation, you kind of have to give people the specifics of, we're going to be demonstrating this new product and this is why it's important to you. You know, because you have to make it super worth their time, right?
Yeah, exactly. And it's, these shows are not just a show and tell either. They're a good place to close deals if you're prepared, but you've got to be aware of each and every customer in the situation.
Right.
So you need to sit down with your promotional people, business development, ABCI type people, and work up a way that is, there's a benefit for doing business at the show. You know, everything needs a little bit of an incentive. There's mm-hmm. So there's nothing wrong with having show specials at all. And not that they have to leave you a Visa card or a check right there, but you can certainly give them a window of benefit. You know, everybody that comes and does business with us within 30 days of the show, you know, it's a benefit, a discount, something along that lines.
Right. Or something added, an additional product or service or something like that.
So. Yeah. And you need to find a reason that you offer the discount and make sure that you explain it to your customers too. It can't be, well, we just give you 20% off.
Right. Then they're just thinking, well, just give it to me anyway. You know,
yeah, it's like going to the furniture store and the chair is $900 retail, but they've got it on special for $299. It's like, what's going on here? I mean, you've got to have a reason and a season for everything. And that can be a lot of different things, but.
Right. Okay. So number one is make appointments. Number two is to plan your presentation. And do you have a number three?
I probably blended in most of them in that. Okay. But, you know, another thing that's really important is, you know, depending on the size of the business, you're going to have key people missing from your primary daily operations.
Ah, yeah.
And so this is some things that I really enjoy, like you, working with companies, because you can't send everybody, you know, into the woods to hunt. Somebody's got to stay home and, you know, take care of the kitchen. You can't send you can't have everybody unavailable, you know, doing the trade show and leave your business vacant.
Yeah.
So that preparation is, okay, what happens when, you know, my key business development team is away? How do I handle that and continue business operations? And usually that is what we like to do is, of course, you know, that's a blend. You leave part of your key people home to keep the fires burning, and then we step in and can shore things up from a sales, business development, marketing side at the show. So they don't lose as much business as they gain.
Exactly. So the answer is not necessarily to make your current staff work twice as hard before, during, and after the show. It is to plan for that workload of doing it correctly, which is a lot of preparation, a lot of work at the show, and a lot of work after the show too. So planning for that workload.
The follow-up side of this thing is probably for another session, but
yeah,
exactly right. But it's going to pull a full, you know, for NBA, the big one, 8 days out of your schedule by the time people travel and set up and go home and get over the travel.
Yeah.
So you've got to have the right people in place and work with companies like ours that can shore things up to lend that additional support.
Right. There's nothing worse than getting home from a trade show with your big pile of leads and then having a big pile of work as well and just not having time to do everything well and having something fall through the cracks.
Yeah.
And usually it's those new leads and things. So.
Right.
Excellent. So that was a really good episode. So quick recap, you want to make appointments, plan your presentation, and plan your staffing for before, during, and after the trade show. And if you'd like some additional help, we have got a lot of services that we're offering for aviation companies on a first-come, first-served basis. Of course, trade shows, they fill up quickly, and this is one of our busiest times of year. But if you'd like us to help you plan and get us on your schedule, get you on our schedule, visit seabrightcompany.com/NBAA for more details about the types of things that we can help you with and what that would involve from your side.